this exactly. I'm sorry for the background noise. And I'm just going to talk about some things in my life and do some tapping while we're at it. So yeah, I'm going to do some mic scratching for now, and then I'm going to put on a cover to the mic. But yeah, today is August 19th. Spanish quiz. That was like our first quiz of the year, I think. It was easy. I'm pretty sure I aced it. But yeah. Okay. Next thing I want to talk about is in my last ramble, I talked about the colognes I wanted to wear this week. Oh my goodness. I am so sorry. I just like kicked the freaking thing. Oh, okay. But yeah. I wore Club the Newly Iconic yesterday. I mean, today. Today to school. And I'm going to be honest. I didn't have the best wearing experience with it. Definitely surprised me. I just didn't enjoy the smell as I normally do. So, this is still an amazing fragrance, don't get me wrong. Super nice. I'll still, like, wear it for sure. It's definitely, like, blue, shower gel, citrus, kind of sweet. It's really good. This is my, like, second favorite blue fragrance. But yeah, I also have a question. Like, these Middle Eastern houses, like, Armaf, like, I don't think Armaf makes anything other than fragrances, which technically makes them niche. It's like, does this count as niche? I don't know. Or it's not designer, it's just a gray area, maybe. Okay, now I'm going to talk about fragrances that I'm going to wear soon. This one, I think I'm going to wear tomorrow. Ishq Al Shayuka Silver. I love this stuff because it's so underrated. And it smells so amazing. It's fruits. A little bit of citrus at the top, pineapple, bergamot, and then some fruits, maybe some pear, apple, pineapple, sweet fruits, and then some woodiness, some nuttiness, some vanilla. It's a 1 million lucky inspired, sort of, with some extra fruits. Super duper nice stuff. Oh. Man. On Wednesday and Friday, my high school does something called high school retreat, where basically they bus the whole high school out to like a camp place, and we stay at that camp overnight, Wednesday to Thursday. So the uploads Wednesday and Thursday might be a little bit, like the timing might be weird, the comments might be turned off or something. Like, just bear with me, I'm not allowed to have my phone at retreat, so for like more than 24 hours I won't be able to like respond to comments and like do content stuff. I'm gonna try and schedule some uploads to see if I can get them up, but yeah, there's that. So I'm just gonna spray this on like my hoodie real quick, like the sleeve of my hoodie. This is so underrated, y'all. It only lasts like 8 hours though. That's a bummer. Shout out to BT Sense for putting me onto this. Sorry if anyone tells me they don't like this fragrance. I am literally gonna be like, I don't care, and wear it anyway. I'm trying to figure out how many sprays I'm gonna wear of this, because I haven't really had an experience wearing it out before. This is gonna be my first time wearing it out, so I'm thinking like one, two, oh crap, and then three, one by the neck, a couple sprays under the shirt, a couple sprays on the jacket, a couple sprays on the shirt. Probably what I'll do. So like around 10 sprays, which is what I normally do. But yeah. Oh, it's so good. Super underrated stuff for sure. But yeah. I'm trying to figure out what else I could talk about that's interesting. Okay, quick break from the colognes. I got a new hairbrush today because my old one was like falling apart. It's super cool. This sounds good. Let me know if you want me to do this for a video. This in the last ramble, but I'm really hoping I can get to the point where I'm uploading on this channel daily, the Bible channel every other day, and the fragrance channel twice a week. But right now, that's gonna be difficult to get to. But I think once I like catch up with everything, I'll be able to do it. I just need to find like more efficient stuff, and I'm gonna try and use like AI and stuff to get like the videos SEO, like search engine optimization, like help grow the channel and stuff. I might change up the thumbnails, change up the scenery, like the recording stuff. Like, I feel like having like my room, my bed and stuff in the back isn't the best. I'm thinking of maybe putting it, I don't know, because I want to have this table, but I don't really have a different table I can record at. And with the ring light, it's like a stand up, like if this is on the ground, and then I'm like at the corner of my table right now. I'll do an around the room video soon, maybe. Also, I've been trying to make like 20 minute videos recently, 20 plus minute videos. It's been very time consuming, but it's been Mondays when it comes to like our friend group, when it comes to like religion, and we're starting like a Thursdays only like boys men's Bible study at school, like right after school, like a club, but not Bible study, prayer group, where we just talk about like prayer requests and like life and stuff like that. We did it a little bit last year and it was really successful, and we're doing it this year and it's gonna be new and improved, so I'm really excited for that. So if you guys can pray that that goes well, that would be amazing. But yeah, okay, back to the cologne talk. I feel like a lot of y'all followed me for my colognes, even though I did do a poll that if I stopped doing colognes, like if y'all would still subscribe. And I've definitely been like getting off, like I haven't been buying as many colognes, and that's kind of because the ones that I do buy are more expensive. I mean, and I think I'm gonna buy some cheaper ones in a little bit, just so I can get some videos out for you guys and get my nose on more things. I really want to get Lamol, like the EDD. Just has really nice, like, fresh vanilla, like, lavender fragrance. It's been one of my favorite fragrances forever. Sorry, that's a tangent. Whatever, I have a lot of fragrances that I really want. One at the top of my list, though, right now is Initio Side Effect, which I think I'm going to be purchasing within the next week, but we'll see. Okay, next fragrance that I want to talk about for a little bit is L'Homme Extrême. Really just because this stuff smells really good and I can't wait to wear it. And yeah, it's super unique, which is something I love. I'm probably going to start wearing it in like a month or so when the temperatures aren't quite reaching into the 90s. Because this is a vanilla, tobacco, plum, cherry sort of fragrance with some almond. So it's pretty like fall / winter smelling. But I mean, you can really wear any fragrance whenever you want. I actually wear this in the summer, so I might wear this soon. I just wanted to say that I'm going to wear this soon, probably. Yeah, it's super underrated, and y'all should check it out. Also, I'm probably going to, like, on my fragrance channel, I have a ton of reviews done on, like, a bunch of fragrances. I think I'm going to redo a lot of those reviews in, like, a better editing style and, like, an update. Because, like, those were done, like, months ago, or, like, a month ago. And fragrances change. My editing style is better. I can be more informational now. So I think I'm going to do some videos, like, under the, like, Latafa Camera after 5 months or something like that. Or no, I've already reviewed Camera. I've already reviewed Dior Homme Intense, so I'll make a video. Dior Homme Intense after 6 months or something like that, you know? Like, talk about how it changed and how it's different and with the new editing style and everything. I'm really proud of the editing style that Ben's Fragrances is adopting. If you want to check out the new editing style, go check out my La Bulle Parfum review video on my Ben's Fragrances channel. Both my other channels are linked in the description, by the way. If you want to go check them out, I've been trying to grow those channels, trying to get them monetized, trying to just expand my sort of YouTube, like, reach, I guess. I want to do different things. But end up making a vlog channel that just doesn't really have a schedule, that's just me, if y'all are interested in something like that, just like my personality, I don't know. Probably in the very far future, though. Extreme. Super good, super unique. I am going to be wearing this soon. I want to check out the EDP too. Next is Dumont Nitro Red, and I want to talk about this because I have been hating on this fragrance for a while, and honestly, I want to take it back. I'm giving this fragrance a second chance. I'm going to wear it 2 or 3 times, like to school or out or something. See how it goes. It's kind of like Rosacea Wasp if you just replaced like the plum in a wasp with watermelon. It's like a very sweet watermelon Jolly Rancher, and then it gets like aquatic and musky, kind of like the Mont Blanc Legend Spirit dry down. And I've pretty much worn it once and then decided that I didn't like it, that I didn't want to wear it anywhere. And I literally, my whole entire family was like, wow, you smell amazing. And I wear cologne every single day and they barely ever say that, so this must be good. Also, I know I'm wearing the same hoodie as the last ramble. I promise it's not the same night. I'm just wearing this hoodie again. Yeah. Side note, I really want to get a Fortnite win with my girlfriend. We've been playing Fortnite more often, like, together. And I really want to get a win with her because we haven't gotten a win yet. I've definitely fallen off. I used to be really good. I used to play, like, in the deep rounds of FNCS. I don't even know. I don't even know how it works anymore. I kind of forgot. Back in like early chapter 2, I think. because I changed my mind on or something like that, and this might end up in that video, so keep an eye out for that. Last fragrance I want to just quickly talk about is Club de Nuit Untold, and that's because I have a lot of thoughts on this fragrance. First off, it's a Baccarat Rouge clone, and I absolutely adore the smell. Sorry for the background noise. I'm going to try and, like, be, like, loud and close enough where you can't hear the background noise. I don't know why it's so loud. Okay, it's gone. I don't know why the plants are so loud right now. But yeah, it's a Baccarat Rouge clone. I love the smell. Actually, so good. It does a great job of capturing, like, the smell and, like, the longevity of Baccarat Rouge, because Baccarat Rouge is special. It lasts super long, but it doesn't, like, scream off your skin. Like, it doesn't, like... it's not super duper loud, if that makes sense. And this, because that, like, even if you spray 10, 11 sprays, you're not going to be, like, super strong smelling, but it's going to last a good amount of time, and you're going to have a decent bubble. I don't know, it's really hard to explain. You really have to, like, witness it for yourself. But it smells great. It smells low-key, kind of feminine, I'm not going to lie. It's definitely, it's like if I wear it, people are, like, not going to be like, oh, you're wearing a perfume. Or, like, a woman's perfume. Soon, but it's definitely for, like, the warmer months, maybe. I don't know if this is just another fragrance I want to test out soon, where I go agnostic to this, like, I go nose blind to this really, really quick, which is an issue because I like smelling myself. Maybe if I spray less sprays, though, like, I'll go less nose blind. Here, I'm gonna spray it on my... I meant to spray one spray, but the atomizer had different plants. Like, it was pointed the wrong way. This fragrance had for like 2 months now, so I'm thinking it's gonna mature and get, like, I'm gonna become less nose blind or something. It's just so good. I love it. The opening is kind of alcoholic, but definitely, like, the saffron, the woods, it's just super nice. For $40, it's a great clone of Baccarat Rouge, and the bottle is just so sick, so cool. But yeah, I think that's all I had to talk about, honestly. I'll probably do another ramble soon. I don't know.